Ini dunia seni murni. Di dalamnya mengalir sungai seniman yang mengalirkan dalam diam minat pekat dan bakat sarat. Dia riuhkan personal rasa.
However, batik in design and as a painting medium is a confluence of various cultures that is synonymous with our identity as a multiracial cosmopolitan Singapore.
It is indeed a timely initiative during this challenging time to remind us never to give up. On this note, I would like to congratulate and convey my deepest appreciation to the master artists presented here today, and it is now my pleasure to declare Lakar Lilin open. Thank you. Have a pleasant evening.
My name is Muhammad Sadali Musbah, born in 1960, now 61 years old. At a teenager's years, I think during late 70s, but practice doing a serious artwork is around 80s, where I work along with Pak Sarkasi Said in Melayan Batik Factory during that days, where I followed him under partly his tutelage till when Melayan Batik was closed due to acid problem when we do printing on textile, everything. So from there I start doing enrichment program with schools like Tanglin Set as a resident artist. And beside that, I practice my own batik painting. There is a young gallery. They call it young gallery for youngsters, I mean school students. During that time, I was influenced by few batik books during that time. Then it happened that Pak Sarkasi said during that time happened to be my neighbors. When after traveling, having a work, then Pak Sarkasi start back at my kampung where Pak Sarkasi do body of work. From there, I start to gain knowledge bit by bit from being by my batik. The challenging part is the color itself, because mostly during that period is more not like what we see, very vibrant. It's more to nature. More to nature type of colors that influenced me, because it's more to the earth colors during that period. If those who have followed my body of work during my early days, I'm doing mostly on nature itself, like flowers, figurative like the Nanyang style, because during that period when we see about batik itself, we was too influenced, maybe partly because I'm young during that time, influenced by the Nanyang style figurative. When I developed with Pak Sarkasi Said, where from there I've seen abstraction works. My philosophy is simple, anything goes, because you need to break the boundaries of batik itself, because there's no limit in batik actually. Because when we have that boundaries, I think it's difficult for ones to explore. Because in batik, the more mystic sometimes, the more mystic you develop, that means you get a new ways of form, as what Mr. Pak Sarkasi have said to me before. Even if you have 5 of the basic knowledge of batik during my early days, you need to break it at your fingertips. That means you will get more than that. The 5 basic of making batik waste lah during that period my early days work. When I first start to develop my batik on velvet. Okay, my batik on velvet, it started after the late 80s, yes. After in the studio with Pak Sarkasi itself, when our place was destroyed by fire during that time, Kampung Pasiran itself. That is on Friday itself. And mostly the blocks that we have, everything during that period. Even I think Pak Sarkasi said also has lost a few of his body of work, the big and bold art pieces were in that studio during that period. So I stopped painting. I stopped painting for quite some time, nearly 5 years. 5 years. After that, a friend of mine asked me, it's so sad that why should I stop? This inspired me to develop batik on velvet. That is the first period where those 3 painting were submit for UOB Painting of the Year, and it was the 3 painting was highly commended by the judge during that period. The title of those, as what I said, is a human concept and belief. In a way that God create human with a concept, even as an artist. This is my ways of thinking. As an artist, there is a reason why you develop. Even in scientific ways, in spiritual soil also, DNA. As what we understand about in Surah Yasin, also have stated about the bones. So, it's my beginning point when I develop my human concept and belief. So, I don't talk much nowadays about my body of work. Because if I talk about arts today, There's no more as what contemporary is all about, could be seen as postmodernism is postmodernism did. It's just like it's about past and history, the beginning with an end. It's like batik, what I see batik in dots, titik dots to the end, also with a dot. So in life also, there's a beginning and there will be end. As what I see in my early days work, there's body of work, when I see Dara, that means the first touch is endless. So my first body of work, when I start develop, until now, even I stop for quite some time, I'm doing AEP program with student. From there, partly I'm still practicing in a way. Even though I never do my waxing, but to teach, to educate, is to bridge. The whole idea of my work is to bridge. For the younger ones who practice about batik, you need to break away from the normal norms. It's very difficult nowadays to talk about the for the young artists. They need to have a link with the seniors. Without the seniors, there's no young artists, especially for those batik younger batik painters. To develop batik is to challenge lah the medium lah, because it's just like printmaking. Batik is just like printmaking. If those who understand about printmaking, it's slightly the same. Only the reverse side. Whether in batik we wax, you apply to preserve the lines or the colors that you want. But for printmaking, either with lino or one, the other way around. So exactly it's the same. As what I said, when people say batik is not painting, batik is not that. To me, it's just like ceramic, it's just like printmaking. So it's a medium only. And people start during that time when said about batik must be with a concept. To me, no. Doesn't mean you need a concept to develop. As what I said, one's got to believe, discipline in whatever they do. That's the most important thing. When I do resident artist in school, even I don't see that to my student that I'm an athlete. I rather to see myself as a craftsman rather than an artist.